Research for decades has shown that there are clear negative influences on human health from environmental exposures. Superfund sites are abandoned or uncontrolled hazardous waste sites that the Environmental Protection Agency has determined may cause harm to human health or the environment. Superfund contaminants can migrate off-site. They can get into groundwater and move through groundwater or surface water. They can get into the soil and travel through the soil. So the contamination is not necessarily isolated at that one site.
If I was living next to a Superfund site, obviously I want it cleaned up as well as it can be. But we always have to balance the benefit and the cost of remediation.
The National Institute of Environmental Health Sciences is funding the UNC Superfund Research Program to better understand the health effects of Superfund contaminants and also how we can remove them or clean them up in the environment. Our Superfund research program is situated within the UNC Gillings School of Global Public Health. We have 5 research projects that are part of the UNC Superfund research program, 3 biomedical projects and 2 non-biomedical or remediation projects. The biomedical projects are focused on the human body and the impacts of Superfund chemicals in our bodies. And the other 2 remediation projects are really looking at what's the level of contaminants in our environment and what are effective ways of removing contaminants from our environment. Project 1 is led by Dr. James Swinburne, looking at oxidative stress and how it triggers DNA damage. Project 2 is led by Dr. Yvonne Roussin, which is looking at the toxicity of trichloroethylene. Project 3 is led by Dr. Rebecca Fry. She is evaluating cadmium-induced toxicity. Dr. Damien Shea is the PI of Project 4, and he is developing passive sampling devices that give us an opportunity to look at contaminants in the environment over a longer period of time. And Dr. Mike Aiken is the PI of Project 5, and he is evaluating how effective bioremediation is at removing specific Superfund contaminants.
We're not the ones that go in and clean up sites, but we do try to develop better methods, develop better data sets that are appropriate for the risk assessment, and working with EPA to bring more science into the area.
Cost can be prohibitive at some cleanup sites, so it's very important to have the biomedical research that's telling us what level is protective of human health.
So our project and our program here is really aimed at improving the scientific basis for doing that risk assessment.
Ultimately, this work will help us to better protect human health and to have a cleaner environment. To effectively clean up sites all across the country, we have to know which methods of cleanup are most effective. Our biomedical researchers will continue to provide information that helps the decision makers who are trying to set protective levels for these contaminants. Everything we learn can then feed into a policy decision.